Black Ops Cold War is finally here. The continuation of the Black Ops universe, and we could not be more excited. We'll be bringing you high quality content throughout the entirety of the year, starting out with the basics. Best settings videos, how to perform better in both multiplayer and Warzone, best class setups, how to rank up quicker, and things you need to know, as well as things you never knew you needed to know. So make sure you are not a part of this 77% that watches our content consistently but hasn't joined the carnage by subscribing to the channel and turning notifications on to personalized. With the wait being over, we now have a brand new year of Call of Duty content to grind out. This year, more than ever, to be honest. With campaign, zombies modes, the continuation of Warzone, and multiplayer, we as players have quite the selection to pick from and a lot of time to invest if you so choose, given the fact that each season in multiplayer will amount to over 1,000 levels to grind out. But that is for another video. The grind this year is going to be intense, but we have the perfect solution for you to help you out, and that is G Fuel Energy. Now is the time to stock up on your favorite flavors, try a new flavor, or try G Fuel for the very first time. Trust me, you won't be disappointed, as it doesn't result in any form of crash, it's sugar-free and gluten-free, low on calories, and tastes amazing. Even better, our friends over at G Fuel have bumped our code to 30% off so that you all can save big at checkout using code CARNAGE. Now, let's go ahead and dive into the awaited details to set you up with the best settings in Black Ops Cold War. Black Ops Cold War settings and game mechanics follow suit with Modern Warfare to a degree. When it comes to playing well, there are several basic things you need to make sure to adjust that will give you an advantage over players that are unaware of these setting changes. Today, we'll be going over several very minimalistic things to change for a better playstyle. If you enjoyed the video, a like rating would be highly appreciated, and with that all being said, let us dive right into the small tweaks that you can make in your settings that will make a huge difference in your gameplay. Though each player has their own preferences and go-tos, the options and suggestions laid out in this video are a good base to go off of for any skill level. I'd recommend starting with what we suggest and then tweaking to your best performance. So let's start off with sensitivity. Sensitivity in Call of Duty is no longer as basic as it once was. In previous titles, you were left with two options, horizontal and vertical stick sensitivity. With newer titles, you are now offered a wider range of options to tweak to perfect your sticks for more precise and catered aiming. Now, of course, horizontal and vertical sensitivity are still important. Typically, whatever you've used in previous titles will maintain itself in Black Ops Cold War, though a good range to stick to is between 6 and 10, I'd say, allowing for precise movement but not too rambunctious to the point where you'll be missing your shots. Though horizontal and vertical sensitivity is more correlated with movement now and not aiming, as they have introduced ADS stick sensitivity as an additional option, so horizontal and vertical will be more important for how quickly you want to be able to turn on enemies and get your first couple of shots on target. The new ADS sensitivity, low zoom, setting allows you to adjust the sensitivity of your sticks while aiming down sights for more precise aim tracking. With the default being 1.0, you are going to want to bump this down anywhere between the ranges of 0.80 and 0.90 for a noticeable difference that will greatly impact your aim. Trust me, you need to try this if you've neglected this setting before. I did so in Modern Warfare and it made all of the difference. The same holds true for ADS stick sensitivity high zoom. However, this applies to mainly snipers and some high zoom scope attachments with magnification over 4 times. For the setting, we'd recommend keeping this at the standard 1.0 as these scopes move slower to begin with. With better aiming being the topic of discussion, let's move on to our aim assist. Aim assist is built into the game that causes your sights to feel sticky while aiming over a player. It benefits your aim significantly, so of course you will want to make sure that it is enabled with slow down aim assist. This is your traditional Call of Duty aim assist, and I would not recommend changing it to anything else. levels. Next up, we want to make sure your stick layout and input is set to where you are comfortable. Head down to the advanced section of the controller settings where you'll be able to adjust more in-depth options. Starting with your stick layout, most players leave this on default. However, the additional selections are similar to previous Call of Duty titles, so select what you usually play on. New options now allow you to cater to stick drift sensitivity with your left and right input threshold scales. For mins, you will want to keep this under 10 typically, and max can be left on default. These options will help fix controllers that are worn and may have looser sticks than a newer controller. Now, let's talk about settings that directly affect your in-game soldier, starting with movements, as there are surprisingly a lot of different settings that pertain to how your character moves. Firstly, unless you're playing a large ground war-like map, Fireteam Dirty Bomb, or Warzone, you are going to want to disable auto move forward and auto sprint, as these will limit your overall control of your soldier and in many circumstances hurt you in certain gunfights. The more precise control you have over your character, the better. The next option you'll want to change is sprint behavior. Set this to hold, as again, this will grant you more control over your character, being able to make quick, jerky movements in comparison to the go-to option, which is going to be less consistent and more finicky. Lastly, there will be many engagements you'll find yourself in where you'll be reloading and an enemy may come around the corner, catching you off guard and could result in a death. However, the sprint cancels reload option can be your solution by simply enabling it. This will allow you to make a split second decision to hold down sprint for just a moment to cancel the reload and immediately go into firing at that enemy target. This is a setting many forget about and can make a whole lot of difference in a higher level of play once you get used to it. Moving over to the graphics tab, we are offered one of the biggest settings changes in Call of Duty in a long time. That is for console players. And that is the FOV, or field of view changer, that can be maxed out at 120. The FOV slider allows you to have a wider view of your surroundings, thus allowing you to see enemies that you normally would not be able to see with the default console FOV. Increasing the FOV slider is beneficial in almost every regard, though it can be difficult to get used to at first. So I'd recommend making slight increases at first so that you can slowly get used to the new perspectives. The ideal range for console users will be between 100 and 110 for ideal gameplay. This will drastically change your awareness of your surroundings and will lead to additional kills, though do take in mind this could affect visuals and FPS in some circumstances. Next on the list is potentially one of the most simple but most important things to disable for a significant increase in performance, and that is in-game motion blur. Whether it be world blur or weapon blur, disable it all. Trust me in this. Blur decreases your ability to see and spot enemies while you move around your territory. The purpose of the feature is for realism, to create an immersive feel for gameplay. However, our focus is to pursue better performance. Blur will decrease your visuals of your surroundings, meaning your ability to see enemies in the distance as well as other objectives. Additionally, in-game blur of any sort has often led to headaches in my personal experience. This feature is relatively new, so if you found yourself getting headaches during long play sessions since Modern Warfare introduced in-game weapon and world blur, this may be that reason. Regardless, you will want this disabled. Now, moving over to the audio tab, let's start with the overall audio preset, where you are given several options: Treyarch Mix, Bass Boost, and High Boost, plus potentially some additional options that could come into game later on. Though this will need testing, as the circumstances for each individual will be different based on your equipment. However, High Boost is what we will be going with, as it helps with footsteps and doesn't drown out sounds like the other options. With that, we are given 5 game sounds that we can adjust to our liking: Master Volume, Music Volume, Sound Effects Volume, Dialogue Volume, and Cinematics Volume. Master Volume will be keeping that at 100, as there really is no reason to change this to any different level at all. If the overall sound of your game is too loud, change your device volume before adjusting the master volume. For music volume, I keep this at 0. Oftentimes, towards the end of games, dramatic music will begin to play, which can interfere with your ability to hear enemy footsteps and callouts. Plus, I just find music in pregame and in-game overall just annoying, so I simply mute it. Dialogue volume, we're going to want turned down, as honestly, the callouts and announcers yelling in my ear all the time throughout the game is a little bit annoying and I don't find all that useful, though at times it can be useful, so I don't want to turn it off all the way, but I'd recommend maybe cutting it in half. And lastly, sound effects are probably your most important. Effects like gunfire, footsteps, and other enemy movements are far more important, and that is why you will make sure your sound effect volume is maxed out, as it is, again, probably the most important of the five. And lastly, cinematics volume can be turned down or off in this case, as it pertains to additional scenes where you aren't playing, nor are you in control of your character, and it's just unnecessarily loud. Now, to leave you off with our last section of tips, we're going to rapid fire through some miscellaneous settings to change that will further better your experience and make sure you are on the right track for better performance in Black Ops Cold War. Starting off with your controller vibration, though you may like this feature and be used to it at this point, I was as well up until Black Ops 4. Disabling this feature will significantly better your gameplay once you get used to it. Having it disabled betters aiming accuracy, stability, and precision. Equipment behavior should be set to hold for more accurate decision making, cooking grenades, etc. On your interface tab, have crosshairs, hit marker visuals, damage based hit markers, enemy health bars, and horizontal compass on shown, and hide ally health bars unless you're playing a mode such as search and destroy where it may be useful. Otherwise, it's just add a distraction to your visual display. Set player names to abbreviated to limit the excess visual distraction. With that all being said, you are now on better track to increase your performance in Black Ops Cold War. These adjustments may seem small, but will significantly change your in-game performance for the better. Additionally, a SCUF gaming controller would also be highly recommended, given the paddles on the back of the controller, which will allow you to bunny hop, slide cancel, and perform other maneuvers easier without having to take your fingers off of other buttons such as the sprint or the triggers. You can use code Carnage to save 5% off all products at scuffgaming.com. Linked in the description, and as stated in the intro, code Carnage will save you up to 30% off all G Fuel products. If you found any of these tips useful, please feel free to refer this guide to your friends, and if you wouldn't mind leaving a like rating if you enjoyed, that would be greatly appreciated. I hope that these setting changes help you for the better, and we hope to see you back on the channel in our future videos. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.